Since I do speed printing, I have problems due to vibrations. Let's improve this with vibration dampers. Now on 24/7 printing. Huge thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring this segment of the video and for hosting the 7th Project Design Contest. Make sure to participate if you have an interesting electronic project, a mechanical project or an STM32 project. You have the chance to win cash prizes up to $1,500 and there are special rewards in various categories. Submit your mechanical, electronic or STM32 project by January 19, 2025. Thanks to PCBWay for hosting these exciting contests and for partnering again with 24/7 Printing. If you are into 3D printing, you might have heard of Shannon, aka Through the Frame. He's a 3D printing and CAD enthusiast who's active on platforms like Printables and Makerspace. One of the most recent designs of Through the Frame is HULA. HULA is an omnidirectional self-aligning anti-vibration foot meant to minimize movement vibrations on 3D printers. Its design is meant to isolate the printer from the surface, absorbing the horizontal XY vibrations common in modern and fast Core XY as well as Batzlinger machines. The goal of HULA is to enhance print quality and to decrease vibrations transferred to surface and nearby printers. Through the Frame teamed up with Voxel, formerly known as Voxel PLA, to distribute full kits including hardware and printed parts for his designs. Voxel also sells kits and assemblies of Through the Frame's HULA. For those of you who don't know about Voxel yet, Voxel is a 3D printing company located in Southern California running a 150 machines print farm. To ensure reliability, speed and toughness on the filaments used for this endeavor, Voxel simply made their own filaments to meet these requirements. On a side note, they sell their print farm approved PLA Plus and PTG Plus starting at $16.99. They offer 10 colors for their high-speed Voxel PETG Plus and 21 colors for their Voxel PLA Plus. $16.99 per kilogram of high-quality filament is hard to beat. Thanks a lot to Voxel for the support on this video. Check out their discounts on bulk orders and free shipping options in the link below. ModBot, Printing Perspective and MPOXDE made interesting videos about the results of HULA used on common printers. You should check them out, I'll link them below. The higher speed and accelerations, the more violent the vibrations become to cope with. My 24/7 Zero modification for Voron Zero allows to go at exceptionally high acceleration and tremendous speeds on a compact and lightweight 3D printer structure. That's an interesting as well as challenging combination to test HULA on, right? Let's dive into that. My 24/7 Zero is a heavily modified version of the Voron Zero, upgraded to push movement, extrusion and cooling further. With low moving mass and enhanced cooling for both the print and components, it achieves extremely fast movement powered by just two small NEMA 14 stepper motors. Vibrations are a constant challenge for this new wave of fast printers and especially for 24/7 Zero. For example, during that 2.5 minute 3D Benchy print at 800 mm per second with an insane acceleration of 200,000 mm per second squared or even at lower speeds, there's still a lot of room for improvement. That's why I wanted to test HULA on this little multi-mass oscillator. I don't expect it to be a universal solution for high-speed printing, but it could be an upgrade for those compressor feet I use currently. It also gives incentives to finally try a bit more around vibration dampening in general, like simply adding weight to the printer. But let's break it down step by step. Through the Frame's HULA is easy to build, consisting of a damper and a core that moves on a thrust bearing. Be sure to check out the detailed instructions for printing and assembly that Through the Frame provided. He also kindly designed an adapter for the widened stance feet of 24/7 Zero. Currently, there are two versions of the TPU damper. The originally released version is softer, while the newer version 1 has a tighter fit with pretension the HULA frame. Since 24/7 Zero is very small and very lightweight, I decided to test both versions against the original compressor foot. HULA is designed to reduce vibration, therefore also noise, but also ringing artifacts during printing. My test setup challenges HULA in these areas. Using a vibrometer app at earthquake MMI scale like Through the Frame did, I measure both maximum and average vibrations along with maximum noise levels in decibels from a fixed distance. I taped the printer to the cutting mat so it can't run away during each test. The first test is a repeated 2 mm short movement at 500 mm per second and 80k acceleration, performed in X direction in Y direction and diagonal XY direction. That will be interesting as moved masses depend on movement direction and correct Y kinematics as we have here. So the first test simulates high frequency movement similar to the solid infill moves in the 7.5 minute 3D Banshee print. The second test involves a repeated 20 mm movement at 1000 mm per second and 120k acceleration, also in X direction, in Y direction and diagonal XY direction. This represents the travel movements as used in that 7.5 minute Banshee print. Finally, the last test simulates the extreme printing and travel moves from the 2.5 minute Banshee print with movements at 800 mm per second and 200k acceleration, again done in all directions. For the printing test, I used the Clipper ringing tower designed for setting up input shaping without an accelerometer. Each segment is printed at automatically increasing accelerations to induce ringing. I ran the test from 15k to 48k in 3k steps. On 24/7 ringing usually starts somewhere between 20k and 40k acceleration, depending on the axis and print speed. Just like in a real-world printing scenario, I set the print speed to 300 mm per second and resonance compensation was active throughout the test. Important side note here, I measured resonances for input shaping for all damping feet used, but differences are negligible. I suspect the induced vibrations testing the extremely lightweight gantry are just too low to force a reaction from the table over the feet and frame back to the tool head. With the original compressor rubber feet, the 2 mm movement at 500 mm per second shows MMI levels ranging from 0 to 3.8, ranging from barely noticeable to dish-rattling vibrations. Noise levels, depending on direction, are in the mid to high 70 decibel range, which is around the level of a vacuum cleaner or hair dryer. The travel move test at 1000 mm per second produces stronger vibrations, with MMI readings between 5, resembling objects fall from shelf in earthquake talk, and nearly 7, resembling heavy furniture overturned. The 200k acceleration doesn't increase vibrations much, but raises the noise level into the high 80 decibels, especially in the XY direction. Using HULA with the actual version 1 damper delivers interesting results. For all of those more violent XY diagonal movements, both vibrations and noise levels remain roughly the same. The short high-frequency moves seem to show slightly amplified vibrations here, but for all the highly accelerated high-speed moves, there is a noticeable reduction in vibrations, while noise levels don't change much. The older version of the damper, which is noticeably softer, does not help further for the short or long moves straight in X or Y. Also, it doesn't reduce noise levels drastically for those, but it helps to bring down vibrations for all the high-speed diagonal moves significantly. For those, there's also slight improvement in the noise levels. All in all, the softer RC2 version seems to be the better choice for this scenario of a lightweight and small but high-performance printer like we test here. By adding weight to 24/7, I hope to achieve two goals. First, to eliminate the need for taping down the printer, which I had to do for all the 3D Banshee videos. Second, I expect the increased mass to reduce frame movement induced by the accelerated mass on the gantry. Testing HULA pushed me to finally design holders for the two 1.7 kg steel weights borrowed from a weightlifter friend long time ago to get in shape. After running the test plan with added weights, it works. Vibrations for the short high-frequency movements are back at around the same level as without HULA. This was the only scenario where HULA was not beneficial. Both the longer high-speed movements at high acceleration decreased significantly in vibration over HULA damper V1 and HULA damper RC2. Noise levels seem also to be slightly reduced, even though not by much. I could not find any difference in the ringing for printing at 300 mm per second from 15k to 48k acceleration, whether for the x-axis nor for the y-axis. My guess is that movement is just not violent enough to have any impact to and from the rubber feet or from HULA, just like it is the case for the input shaping results. I speculate though, if I tried another fastest, ugly 3D Benji on record, maybe someday HULA and for sure the weight could help for improved quality. To summarize and conclude, how effective is HULA? Based on my experiences I showed today and based on what I know from other YouTubers, it depends. And this makes sense, as vibration dampening is a complex topic with many variables. The design and effectiveness of dampers, whether it's the feet or the additional mass used, depends on factors like the printer's moving mass, frame weight, movement speeds as well as acceleration, movement directions, and maybe even personal sensitivity to vibrations and noise. For instance, after some of the heavier vibration tests, I actually felt a bit dizzy and nauseous afterwards, which shows how personal sensitivity can also play a role. HULA offers kind of a clever starting point for addressing vibrations, but it also encourages experimentation, as there's for sure no one-size-fits-all solution for vibration dampening. Let's thank Shannon, aka Through the Frame, for publishing his designs for free, and Voxel for partnering and supporting guys like him. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, subscribe. Support me on Patreon. Every contribution helps me get closer to doing YouTube full-time, as well as way more frequently. Thanks a lot, habe die Ehre, and good. Huge shout out to our 24/7 printing gold patrons, Eric Jung and Gutsby.